So let us take a couple of questions on this. Okay, draw a square like this.
Four root two
cos 45, which is 4 by root 2, cos 45 is 1 by root 2 meter per second. So this is 4 meter per second, V4x. And now if you substitute there, you will get the answer. Simple enough? Okay. Now tell me, similarly VCMy, if you have to find out, it will be M1 into V1y plus M2 into V2y and so on. So I should know V1y, V2y. So what it is? V1y is what? 0. V2y? Minus 2. V3y? Minus 3 sine 30. Which is minus of 3 by 2 meter per second. V4y is what?
Plus 4.
It is plus 4. The component of velocity along y-axis is positive. So it is 4 root 2 sine 45. So this will be 4 meter per second. So you can get VCM along y-axis also. Total velocity will be what? Square root of VCM x square plus VCM y square. Okay, and how to find the direction of VCM? Tan inverse of Vy by Vx. That angle you make from the x-axis. Okay, so that's it for the velocity of center of mass. There are not such questions which we have solved for location of center of mass for the velocity of center of mass. Are you getting it? Is this thing clear?
Yes,
no doubts?
No doubts, sir.
Take it. Lego. Acceleration of center of mass. So, acceleration of center of mass has some physical significance because acceleration is directly correlated with the force. Okay? So, when we find acceleration of center of mass, it will have a direct implication. And let's see how it is. Alright? Stop talking now. So we have till now found out VCM. Let's take three or four particles like this. M1, R1, not R1, V1. M2, V2, so on, divided by M1 plus. How to find out the ACM? How will you find acceleration if VCM is given? Differentiate it, right? So ACM is dVCM by dt. This will be equal to, now if you differentiate V1, it will give you what? A1. Okay, so M1 A1 plus M2 A2 and so on divided by M1 plus M2 like that. Right? Okay. Now, what is M1 A1? Force on M1. Net force on M1. Yes or no? This is what? Net force on M2. Can M2 apply force on M1? Of course, it can apply. Right? If collision happens between M1 and M2, they are applying force on each other. Okay? So M1 can experience force from the neighboring masses as well as from outside. Yes or no? Okay? So this will be equal to sum of the all the forces on M1. Write it down like this. Plus summation of all the forces on M2 and so on divided by M1 plus M2. Like this into ACM. And let's say sum of all masses is capital M. Mass of the entire system is capital M. Okay? So denominator I can write it as capital M. So ACM is summation of forces on M1, M2 and so on divided by the total mass of the system. So summation of all forces on M1, summation of all forces on M2 and so on is what? M into acceleration of center of mass. Now tell me, when you add up all the forces on the system like this, what will happen? This has, suppose summation of force on M1 has force what M2 is applying on M1 as well. So summation of all forces on M2 will have a force which M1 applies on M2. So what will happen when you add it up? That force will become zero, whatever is between them. So all the internal forces will get cancelled away. If you add up all the forces on individual masses, the force which they are applying on each other will get cancelled away. Are you getting it? So what will be the leftover? Net external force. External to what? External to entire system. Fine? So this equation will transform into summation of all forces external to the system is equal to mass into acceleration or center of mass. This looks like Newton's second law, right? Now you know why location of center of mass was defined the way it was defined, and now velocity, why it has come like that. Because location was defined like that, that is why the final expression of force looks like this. Okay, so the way you have defined helped you to get a similar expression as that of Newton's second law for the system also. Getting it? Alright, now if, by the way, let's take a component also here. Summation of external force along x-axis will be what? Mass into acceleration of center of mass along x-axis. Similarly, external force along y-axis, mass into acceleration center of mass along y-axis, and similarly for the z-axis as well. Logical, the way we have done for the particle in the laws of motion chapter, similar way. Alright? Now, something very important. If summation of external force is zero, what does it mean? Acceleration of center of mass is zero. ACM is zero. So this implies A center of mass is zero. And if A center of mass is zero, what does it mean? Velocity of center of mass is constant. With constant velocity, acceleration is zero, nah? Right? And if all these ifs are there, and on top of it, if velocity of center of mass initially was zero, what it will be? Will the velocity of center of mass will be zero always? Right? Because VCM is constant, and initial velocity of center of mass was zero. So all the time velocity of center of mass will be zero. And if VCM center of mass is zero, it implies what? Location of center of mass is constant. Location of center of mass is constant. The center of mass location won't change. Even if the particles can move here and there, but center of mass location will be fixed. This is called conservation of center of mass. This thing. And when conservation of center of mass is valid? When net force is zero and initial velocity of center of mass is zero. Please write down. Center of mass location will be conserved. Center of mass location will be conserved if center of mass location will be conserved if external force will be zero. If external force is zero and initial center of mass velocity is zero. Center of mass location will be conserved if external force to the system is zero and the initial velocity of center of mass is zero. Got it? Understood? Right? Now, if you would have paid attention to velocity of center of mass definition, Right, pay attention. Shh. If net external force is zero, if net external force is zero, V central mass is constant or not? Constant, right? And VCM is what? What is M1 V1? Momentum of M1. So numerator is what? Sum of all the momentums. So if VCM is constant, can I say entire momentum is constant? And this is what conservation of momentum is. If net external force is zero, VCM is constant, and VCM is basically sum of all the momentums, all the linear momentum divided by the total mass. This is VCM. So if external force is zero, VCM is constant, and hence sum of all momentums will be constant. And this is what is conservation of momentum that we had used in work for energy chapter. Okay, so you can derive it like that also, conservation of momentum. Fine. So if VCM velocity is not zero, you can only conserve momentum. If VCM was zero, apart from conservation of momentum, you can also conserve. Alright, so this is delta x for this problem in which small m is kept at the top of the incline and slides down. You have to find out how much capital M will move. Okay? So delta x is this much. Now tell me, if there is a friction between small m and capital M, the answer will be less than this, more than this, or same as this? Same. Same, because your system is small m and capital M, that is the internal force. Are you getting it? It does not matter. As long as this surface is smooth. Okay? Alright, so we will start the fourth.